Mark, this will be the biggest overhaul to the nation's defences in nearly four decades. The Defence Strategic Review was announced by the Albanese government in August. It was returned to the government in February, and today a 110-page declassified public version of it will be released. Right now, an initial briefing into its findings is underway here at Parliament. We are then expecting to hear from the Prime Minister and Defence Minister Richard Miles in the next half hour or so. It's anticipated they'll make a series of announcements around future defence investments, guided by the new priorities and the new direction of the ADF. In a nutshell, it will shift focus less on defending our border and more on holding potential enemies far away from it. So that's moving away from land-based forces, things like armoured vehicles, and moving toward long-range strike capabilities. It's expected the government will more than double funding for guided weapons and will fast-track the purchase of long-range strike missiles.
What you'll see is announcements and investments to give the Australian Defence Force a focus on long-range strike to deter any potential adversary and to contribute to peace and stability in our region. We'll be very clear that we will be reducing in scope or delaying projects that are less impactful, that have a lower priority than the announcements we're making.
So you can chuck in everything you want, but your retention rate is the worst it's ever been in history, and people are not joining. For goodness sake, if we have a war, there goes my Senate seat, I'll have to go and pick up a weapon out of the armoury.
The review is also expected to prioritise cybersecurity and space capabilities, underwater sea mines, and the nation's northern air force bases. Largely, Mark, in response to an increasingly aggressive China in the midst of what the government acknowledges are the most challenging strategic circumstances we've faced since World War II. Mark.
Welcome back. You're watching Today. The most significant defence review in decades will be released today, which is expected to fast-track our purchase of long-range missiles as tensions grow across the Indo-Pacific. Joining us to discuss is Tasmanian Senator Jackie Lambie and commentator Scott Emerson. Thank you both so much for your time. Jackie, I want to start with you. This is the most significant review into the Defence Force in a decade. It seems like we're stepping up our role in the Indo-Pacific. What are your thoughts?
Look, I haven't seen the white paper yet, like many others, I suppose. We found it bizarre that they're actually giving it the day before Anzac Day, considering, you know, I would have left it later till during the week, because I imagine there'll be a lot of debate going on and talking about by lunchtime on that. Look, what we do know is you can chuck in everything you want, but your retention rate is the worst it's ever been in history, and people are not joining. For goodness sake, if we have a war, there goes my Senate seat, I'll have to go and pick up a weapon out of the armoury. What I do know is even all of us that have served, mate, there is not enough weapons for us anyway. So, you know, we are in dire straits when it comes to our national security here in the country, but it's certainly cyber, missiles, IA. I'd expect to see all that and drones, and I'd expect to see a lot of money spent on that. My other thing is this. Where is the money coming from? Because if you're going to tour it out of that, are you going to take it out of the land forces? Are you going to take it off Army? That's usually what happens. So if you stack either the Air Force or Navy up, it has to come out of one or two of the others. So it'll be very interesting to see what that review looks like.
You would be some force on the front line, Jackie, just saying. I wouldn't be standing in your way, that's for sure. But this is the thing, isn't it? I mean, you've got to take it from somewhere to give to this.
Yes.
We're talking about billions of dollars over the forward estimates.
Yeah, absolutely billions of dollars. Like you said, you must take it from somewhere else. So does it come from one of those other two forces?
Yeah.
Or is it coming from, you know, so we have to talk about this. Although it needs to be done.
This is the thing, isn't it? I mean, Scott, all of this really is obviously targeted towards the escalating tensions with China. What do you think we can expect now from China in response?
Look, it'll be very interesting to see. I mean, we'll see the same sort of comments from China we've seen over the last year or so, especially since the AUKUS announcement. China will say we're overreacting, they pose no threat. But what this report by Stephen Smith and Angus Houston has identified is, compared to the DIB report 40 years ago, where it talked about low-level threats, this is all about the Indo-Pacific, all about China. They won't name China in this redacted report, but it's all about China. And it's all about being able to stop China coming into the waters of significance for Australia. So it may mean, as Jackie said, possibly downgrading our army, increasing our navy and air force. And where will the money come from? Over the long term, most likely it'll be cost neutral. The money will be the same. but it'll be interesting to see what it'll be in the short term. Mm. Jim Chalmers is trying to balance his budget. This doesn't make it any easier.
No, it certainly doesn't. Let's go to the popularity contest that is politics in this country. In the latest news poll, both Anthony Albanese and Peter Dutton have been dealt their lowest approval ratings since the election. Jackie, you're not surprised, are you?
No, the Lambies are coming, mate. We're coming. We're coming without any cash on the smell of an oily rag, but we're coming.
You are most welcome. What do you reckon? Do you think the country, the honeymoon period is over for these two? Well, one of them anyway.
Yeah, I think the honeymoon period's been over for a long time, but we'll see how we go.
What do you reckon's behind the fall, Scott?
Oh, I don't think Peter Dutton's gone through a honeymoon period at all, Sarah, as you've indicated there. And I think there is a certain honeymoon period coming off for Anthony Albanese. But to be honest, I think that the voice itself, the debate over the rancour, it's divisive, and I think that the public doesn't like it. It might like the idea of recognition for Indigenous Australians, but just the nature and tone of the debate, I think people are marking down both leaders over that.
Yeah, it is getting a little bit ugly, isn't it? It's certainly a big mess at the moment. All right, well, the world continues to pay tribute to legendary icon Barry Humphries, who we all know has left behind an incredible legacy and so many laughs to us all. Jackie, do you have a favourite Barry moment? A favourite?
Well, possums, I'm glad you asked. But I think certainly him coming to Tasmania, unlike Carl, he had a free ride. We didn't need to stamp his passport. So I don't think you can pick one moment with Barry. He's been around for so long. I mean, everybody just loved him, didn't they? So probably didn't see as much of him over the last probably 10 or 15 years as what we certainly did when I was younger and growing up. Makes me feel bloody old. But, you know, I mean, what an absolute bloody legend that bloke was. Absolutely.
Absolutely part of the Australian fabric. Yeah. You know, we all have fond memories of him. Scott, is there one that stands out for you?
Oh, look, I love Dame Edna. And even more recently, there's so many over so many years, but even him kind of getting into the seat next to the King and the Queen now, just hilarious. And look, he finally, the usher comes in and says, oh, look, and gives him the ticket and speaks to him, and Dame Edna says, oh, they found me a better seat.
Yes.
I just thought that was hilarious.
He was so smart.
And he brought Australian humour and to the world. That is the real legacy of Barry Humphries.
Absolutely. You're not wrong. Possums, thank you both so much for your time.